Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions that you have about your world and my world. First question up, Appy asks, Dear Blocko, how can I live on the moon? Can it grow things? How much does it cost to get there? Well, humans first stepped on the moon back in 1969, and now NASA's Artemis program has hopes of sending the next man and first woman to the moon by 2024 to learn more about the lunar surface. Some of their goals are to learn about how to work with the lunar soil, known as regolith, so that astronauts can drive long distances across it and even build infrastructure on it. Regolith is a mix of rocks, pebbles, and dust, can be quite sharp, and has been described as having a similar texture to baking flour. So really, not just any normal car can drive on it. And imagine trying to build a house on top of that kind of material, or just trying to get a space garden set up there. That said, researchers have had some initial success growing plants in simulated regolith, not actual regolith from the moon's surface, with foods like tomatoes, rye, and peas. Still though, the soil is just one aspect of growing plants. Let's just assume there won't be a giant space garden anytime soon. As far as cost, by the way, one NASA administrator said that the Artemis program could cost anywhere between $20 and $30 billion. So let's hope your piggy bank has a lot of quarters in it. Next question up, Leon asks, Dear Blocko, why does everyone's voice sound different if we have the same voice box? This is a great question. To answer this, let's understand a little more about how human speech actually works. It's more than just your voice box that gives you the unique voice that you have. Whenever you say something, air from your lungs passes through your larynx, which is also called your voice box. Attached to the larynx are your vocal folds, or vocal cords. When these vibrate, sound is produced, and these vocal folds help determine the pitch of your voice, how high or low it sounds. From here, the sound still has to travel through your vocal tract, the airway, and out to your nose and lips. And the unique shape of your vocal tract causes the sound to change, giving you your unique sounding voice. Anyway, now it's time for a question about me and my world. Jay Xander asks, Dear Blocko, is Mako still annoying you and your town? Okay, for those of you who don't know, Mako is my evil twin. He thinks I'm his arch nemesis, but again, I couldn't care less about the guy. Oh really, Blocko? Not even if I steal your soon-to-be wife? Ha 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 ha. Mako, that's not my wife. That is several wheels of cheese stacked on top of each other. Actually, I'm not entertaining this. I really gotta go. Hey, wait. Why don't you ever wanna be my arch nemesis? I do evil things around the city. I'm basically you, but evil. And have a mustache. I mean, you've never even stopped to ask if we're even related. I just don't really need an arch nemesis right now. Well, what if I told you I'm the one releasing those data muncher bugs all over the life noggin world? I don't believe you. Why not? Well, is it you? No. Couldn't you just, like, pop the hot air balloon that I have or something? Just pretend you hate me. Ugh, okay, fine. Happy? You've done it this time, Blocko! This means war! Come on, Seclia, you're coming with me! Anyway, do you have any questions about your world and my world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.